Do you know Shangjie? As the fifth brand of Harmony OS intelligent mobility, Shangjie H5 was born with Huawei's top intelligent configurations and the manufacturing background of SAIC. With a pre-sale price starting from 169,800 yuan. So what is the experience of Huawei ADS 4.0, whose price has dropped to the 200,000 yuan level for this first time? And what kind of surprises can Shangjie H5 bring to the 200,000 yuan level market? We have matched a best-selling competitor in the same class for the top-of-the-line Shangjie H5 Max version, the Tesla Model Y, to conduct a comparison in three aspects: full scenario navigation, activity, and automatic parking. Additionally, for people who think the basic edition is sufficient, we also present a comparison of the performance of Shangjie H5 Pro Edition and the BYD Song Plus in highway navigation. And let's first take a look at the version configurations of the four vehicles. For these familiar road conditions such as the tidal lines, reverse traction, detours, electric toll collections, etc., we have set a 150 km road based on the principle of the using difficult problems to create a gap, including 95 km of highways and elevated road and 20 km in urban area. An urban section will encounter various high difficulty scenarios. Among them, Shangjie H5 Pro Edition and the Song Plus EV Intelligent Driving Edition only assess highway navigation performance. And let's first look at the driver intervention situation of the four vehicles. On the highway section, only the drivers of Shangjie H5 Pro and the Max version did not intervene. On the urban section, the Shangjie H5 Max version also performed well, with the only two interventions, both due to the deadlock with oncoming vehicles on narrow road. In addition to the cost deviation issue with the Tesla Model Y, it has also experienced a strange problem where it failed to start when the traffic light turned green, as well as an instance of collision risk. On the highway section, there are a total of 6 ramps. Both the Shangjie H5 Pro and the Max version took the correct road. Both BYD Song and the Tesla Model Y took the wrong turn once and on the highway. The BYD Song was supposed to take the next ramp, but under a nearby ramp prematurely. The Tesla, on the other hand, went straight when it should have turned into the ramp and was correct by the driver before entering the correct intersections. On the urban road, Shangjie H5 Max still did not take a wrong turn, but Tesla once failed to enter the right turn lines in time. We have 5 highly difficult inspection points throughout the precise. Most assisted driving systems in the industry have not yet mastered these traffic rules. And let's first look at how the Shangjie H5 Max version and Tesla Model Y handled them. In the past, even the ADAS that claimed to be usable across the country would downgrade when approaching an ETC lane. Both the ADS 4.0 of Shangjie H5 Max Edition and FSD V13 of the Tesla Model Y has enabled the highway ETC function. For driving up to the lane, waiting for the barrier to lift, to smoothly driving from the unmarked area onto the main road, both vehicles have performed well. And next come to the most challenging part, parking spot to parking spot. The starting parking spot for us is a dead end. And looking at the destination, all the parking space in the underground parking lot here are mechanical parking spots. After the Shangjie H5 Max selected to the destination, it activates the function wheel stationary. The just is positioned, driving from the internal road to the parking gate. slow down when encountering a crossing vehicle halfway, and then passes the battery gate smoothly and turn right to merge into the main road. Upon reaching the destination, the Shangjie H5 Max Edition descended two levels after routing, basement, garage, and parking in the mechanical parking space. And Tesla Model Y failed to starting a U-turn, and the driver manually completed the U-turn. Subsequently, it smoothly passed through the barrier gate, exited parking, and merged onto the main road. And when reaching the destination, the Tesla Model Y encountered a problem. After driving took over manually, they reactivated the function to enter the B2 underground parking lot. However, the vehicle comes to a halt when it fails to recognize the parking spot on either side, instead of continuing to search for one. As the pause lasted over 5 seconds, the driver switched back to manually driving. Tesla FSD park-to-park function can handle connection in ordering scenarios, but when faced with high-difficulty parking spots, it still requires the driver's participation. In comparison, Huawei 8S has a higher functional upper limit. Reverse construction detours are a scenario that many assistant driving systems often struggle to handle. The construction detour we encountered this time also had a relatively large asymmetric angle, but both the Shangjie H5 Max Edition and the Tesla Model Y were able to find their way. And let's take another look at the recognized capabilities of the two vehicles for road traffic signs. At some intersections with heavy traffic, dedicated right turn lines are installed. Such independent red lines are easily overlooked at complex intersections. Shangjie H5 Max Edition actively supports after detecting a red light and then turn right after the red line goes out. Tesla Model Y fails to recognize the traffic signal and run a red light. The most challenging part is special lanes, tidal lanes, variable lanes, and bus lanes. In particular, the first two types of the lanes also rely on dynamic traffic lights, and this is a difficulty point that all current automakers are researching. After actual testing, we found that the Shangjie H5 Max version can already recognize the above three types of lanes. So when passing through tidal lines and variable lanes, they are both displayed on the SR interface. And when encountering a bus lane, it will also be displayed on the SR interface, and the vehicle will choose to avoid it. Tesla Model Y chose to enter the auxiliary road, avoiding direct confrontation with tidal lanes and variable lanes, and even drove into the bus lane with only traffic restrictions. In addition to above scenarios, there may also be some dangerous situations when using the car, such as encountering construction work and impolite drivers. We recreated this situation on the scene. Only the Shangjie H5 Max version and Tesla Model Y on the seat can activate the navigation function, and both performance quite well. We set up a reverse construction detour scenario with a very large encroachment range, and then increased the speed of the two vehicles to 120 km/h and activated the navigation function. Shangjie H5 Max Edition will first cross and decelerate, trigger a warning, and then pass at a speed of about 50 km/h. And Tesla Model Y will cross and decelerate to a speed of 55 km/h to pass through. The performance of the two vehicles demonstrates that the advanced driver assistant driving can solve such problems, and the experience is very reassuring. There is a sudden door open queue situation ahead. Both Shangjie H5 Max Edition and Tesla Model Y can quickly identify special obstacles such as the car doors and the detour around them. When faced with a car suddenly cutting in front of the blind spot, both the Shangjie H5 Max version and Tesla Model Y can recognize it, but they respond differently. Shangjie H5 Max Edition will decisively decelerate and detour. Tesla Model Y will slow down and stop in place, and only start moving again after waiting for a long time with no response from the other cars. Another dangerous scenario is when the driver becomes unwell and loses consciousness. A few OEMs have launched disability assistance function for this situation. When the advanced driver assistance system detected the driver has it, it will slow down and pull over, and also honk a horn and make an emergency call. In this test, only the Shangjie H5 Max version provides these functions. If you don't turn on the navigation assistance functions, only the active safety function can help in case of an emergency. In this case, we tried three scenarios. Construction sites are not within the AEB response range of Tesla, but the Shangjie H5 Max version can issue a warning and trigger AEB at a speed of 125 km per hour, braking steadily. When the vehicle in front immediately avoids a cone upon encountering it, it leaves little reaction time for the following vehicle. For active safety system, one difficulty is identifying short cones. Tesla Model Y cannot recognize them. However, the Shangjie H5 Max version can come to a stop, and even at 95 km per hour, it triggers EAS moving into the adjacent lane to avoid a cone. And finally, there is a reverse two-wheeled vehicle. In such a situation, even braking may not work. The Tesla Model Y cannot handle it, but the Shangjie H5 Max version triggers EAS at a speed of 80 km per hour and bypasses this two-wheeled vehicle. After seeing the test results, I have to admit the LiDAR and 40mm wave radar of the Shangjie H5 Max are nothing short of a game changer. The above performance is currently exclusive to the Max version, and the Shangjie H5 Pro version without LiDAR does not have an EAS function. The same basic version of the BYD Song Plus does not have this function. However, I would like to popularize the size here. The active safety function cannot cope with all scenarios. Moreover, real-life hazardous situation may not match the test scenario today. Therefore, if the driver encounters a dangerous situation, you should prioritize take control of the steering wheel to avoid it. In fact, when it comes to standalone automatic parking, all this model can park in various types of spots. However, BYD recently officially announced its automatic parking comparable to level 4 capabilities, and this definitely called for a comparison. Extremely narrow parking spaces are ideal scenarios for automatic parking to shine. If you come home and find your parking spot partially occupied, how narrow a space can each of these four vehicles' automatic parking function handle? The Pro and Max version of Shangjie H5 perform similarly in parking, being able to park well in a space 0.4 meters wider than the vehicle width. And can recognize parking space in a space 0.3 meters wider than the vehicle width, but the front of the vehicle cannot fully enter. After the BYD Song Plus activates the function, it can park a space that is 0.8 meters wider than the car, but it cannot recognize a space that is 0.7 meters wider. Tesla Model Y does not have the Remote Valet Parking Assist RVAP function. It can only active automatic parking. It can at most help the driver park in a space that is 0.6 meters wider than the car. And this year, Huawei launched the Viva architecture using the World Mode to elevate Huawei ADS assistant driving to a new level. And now, Shangjie H5 has entered the mass consumer market with the Viva architecture, become the watershed for intelligent experience in the 200,000 yuan market segment. Have any of the above features impressed you? If you have a budget of 200,000 yuan, which of these models' features today would you ultimately choose?